Dave Burkett stated that because people will like it.
Okay.
Shame.
What does it matter if they make the playoffs? It doesn't.
It kills their draft stock. It makes it harder to get a difference maker.
If we're going to do this, answer these calls for this one segment, just two things. Number one, can we just agree that we both know they are not tanking to get a better draft pick? Is that fair? They have no interest in losing games down the stretch. Do you agree with that?
They're idiots.
Okay, but do you agree?
Sure.
Okay. Secondly, damn you for making me listen to that John Taffer podcast from 2 weeks ago. I can't stop watching Bar Rescue.
Shut it down.
Ridiculous. I saw a great episode last night.
New episode, Always Aggravated, up on iTunes and radio.com. Thanks. Best case scenario, playing the Bears in the playoffs. Hard to beat them three times.
Love it.
Mike, let's not let idiots ruin our day. Let's go back to bashing U of M. It's so much more enjoyable than Lions talk. Lifelong Lions fan, don't want them in the playoffs. Let it burn. Jeff's an idiot.
Thank you.
Get with the program, Mike. You always, all caps, root for the home team without fail ever. That's what a fan is. No, that's what a lemming is. He's on drugs. I'm a Lions fan. I don't want them making the playoffs.
That guy's a liar, because if it came down to a game at Green Bay, he'd be rooting for his Lions to make the playoffs.
I'm a Lions fan. I want to see them lose. They've already ruined my year by winning and ruining next year, too, from Dave. See? Glenn is in Detroit. He will lead us off today. Glenn, hello.
Hey, guys. Just to chime in, if you're going to talk about the average fan and a true fan, the average fan just goes to a game just because it's like a play or something. They're just going to see something. A true fan wants to see competing for championships. Like, what's the point of going to the playoffs if you're going to get trounced? Like, if the Lions go 6-10, they can get the 10th seed or get the 10th ranked draft pick. If they go 8-8 and somehow sneak in, they're going to get the 21st pick. Why the hell would you destroy your future for a meaningless game? It would be absolutely pointless. Look at what they did with the draft in 2013, where they got Ziggy Ansah, Darius Slay, Larry Warford. Those were foundational pieces that it got with a top five pick.
Yeah, but Glenn, I think you're missing the point. I think you're missing the point. It's not about what you or I want. It's about what that organization is going to do. They're going to do their best to win these games down the stretch.
Which is counterproductive and short-sighted and stupid.
So at that point, just enjoy the byproduct, which is a playoff appearance.
No.
But it's not enjoyable.
Thank you.
A playoff appearance. It's
Thank
just
you.
An appearance. Who gives a crap?
It's garbage.
Right,
Glenn.
Because we see so many playoffs around these parts,
you know,
right?
Glenn.
About playoffs?
Glenn.
Oh, wait, now we don't care about playoffs.
The hell with it.
If you're not going to compete for a championship in the playoffs,
Glenn, we live in a society, we live in an area where the bar is to win a freaking playoff game. That's it. If this team were to win a playoff game, they would make a statue out of Stafford and Patricia and Quinn and all of them. So give me a break. Now we're talking playoffs don't matter. That's such nonsense.
So I'll tell you what.
You poison the well. These are your people.
You're
going to
carry the water for Tom Gorris while you're at it?
Now I want them to lose tonight.
Well, I mean, you got two hands. You may as well put something in the other hand. You want to hold Tom Gorris's hand for the dishonest garbage that team is? You're going to tell me making the playoffs exciting?
No,
I should root for it?
No, I'm not. This is a different situation, though.
No, it's not. It's the exact same situation.
It absolutely is a different situation.
Exact same situation.
The quicker people realize that it doesn't matter what you root for because the organization isn't going to do it, just take what you can take. And that's a little enjoyment out of a season that's crap.
I got to tell you something, and I mean this. Because I do like you personally.
Oh, thank you.
You're an absolute loser. Like, you are, honestly, what you have just...
So we're all Lions
fans. That take that you just burped out, that is that should be on your gravestone. You are...
It's too long.
You are a loser.
Gotta pay by the letter.
You just told people, don't ever ask for more.
That's
nonsense.
Take
what you can get.
That's not what I said.
Even if it's 60 years of garbage... It's okay. You know what?
Holy hell, dude.
I will pay for a gravestone big enough to put that on there. You are a loser.
And I love Coke. We've been bitching and moaning and wanting and needing for 60 years. Do we ever get any of it? No. So at some point, you just got to say, entertain me for a night. Entertain me for a couple hours. I mean, just stop, dude. Like, sometimes you take this... You should be embarrassed. You should lose a little too far.
Why?
You're talking to people. You're talking to people that have been destroyed by this team.
You know what?
Yeah.
Then that's their fault.
How is that their fault?
Easy. Because I could have
been.
You still
a Giants fan? Yes, you are. Despite what they do, you can't just quit your fandom.
87, 90. We went to the Super Bowl in 2000. We went 7-1. We went 11-1. Yeah, same thing as the Lions.
That's why you are in no You can't talk about it.
What are you talking about?
Because you don't know what it's like.
Sure, I do.
You didn't grow up around it.
I grew up an Islanders fan. And you know what I did instead of let them destroy me? I destroyed them, and I left, and I gave up.
Yeah, so
you know why? Because I knew it was fruitless. I knew whether it was Mike Milbury or whether it was Gart Snow or the names and faces would change, but it would always be bad. Just like dealing Pierre Turgeon or dealing Roberto Luongo or drafting Rick DiPietro or saying Martin Straka couldn't play or signing, you know, or trading for Kirk Muller or even letting Johnny Tavares walk away, right? Weren't smart enough to trade him, couldn't sign him. My whole point is.
Got his 19th goal yesterday, by the way.
I'm happy for him. The point is, I left. I gave up. I quit.
Yeah, but that's not realistic to ask your listeners to do the same. No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Then you would not have any listeners.
Yes, I would.
No, you wouldn't.
Yes, I would. This team doesn't provide us with anything.
It's nonsense.
The Lions don't do anything for us.
Stop. One time in your life, just stop and realize that a fan wants to see their team, I don't know, go to the freaking playoffs. It's not all, oh, this sucks. Everything sucks. It does suck. So why not take the little bit you can get and enjoy it?
Because what you're doing is like a cash advance from Montel Williams. You're going to pay 50% VIG on it. You are asking for joy today and robbing yourself tomorrow.
But
why do you think Montel is up there telling you, hey, baby, come get some sugar? And then in the fine print, you got to put your face up to the TV to go, geez, what are these poor people got to do to get this cash? And you look down there and it goes, your right testicle and $1 million. Jeff, you're screwing next year so you can just get your wick wet for 10 seconds year. That's not how it works.
But again, you go away from the original premise, which is they have no interest in losing to get that better draft pick. So with that being the reason, just enjoy. By me, like I have any clout. Like what I say is going to change the mind of Bob Quinn, who never talks to the damn media anyhow, right? Like I'm going to change the mind of Martha.
You have been asking good questions down there, though, Jeff. I will say that.
Yeah, they don't answer any of them.
What's your next question to Stafford going to be?
Matt, the fans are wondering why you just take money and don't perform.
Oh! All right, I got you. Where are you from?
Something like that.
Yeah, Matt, the fans don't think you'll ever win. Matt, do you think you'll win?
Matt, do you think you quit so far? Are you engaged? Do you give a damn? Those types of things.
Have you quit on the team?
Yes.
248-539-9797. We'll take more to calls next.
Goodbye.
I hate every. No, you're not leaving.
Hey, Vay, come on.
No, you're not. No, you're not. This is your penance. This is your scarlet letter to wear. You started this crap, you will sit here and deal with these people. Why? What are you going to do? Go home and give the kid a bath? We know that ain't happening.
Kid's at daycare, dude. Got to pick her up later.
Yeah, good, so you can bring her in here with mustard on her face.
So that's what it's come to, right? You know I'm right in this argument, so now you got to bash my kid?
No, it just shows you.
Ridiculous.
It just shows you're beaten. It just shows you're beaten. You're a beaten man.
Who the hell would not be beaten?
You're letting the Lions off the hook. You're beaten.
Holy crap. I'm not letting the Lions off the hook.
You got an announcement today? You're going to take a job at DetroitLions.com, get that company car while you're at it?
I mean, yeah, if they pay more, why not?
97-1.
Well, Mike, hopefully this cheers you up right here. The best.
Soft as an effing bunny.
Best time.